Mercenaries have always been intriguing characters exploited in action movies. The identity and story of these soldiers are always a mystery. In Extraction, viewers follow the story of Black Ops mercenary Tyler Rake, as he embarks on a dangerous mission to rescue a hostage, who is the son of a criminal lord. What drives them to undertake such perilous tasks? Is it for money or something else? Welcome to the movie recap area. Let's find out what motivates this mercenary to be so determined to complete the mission regardless of the dangers involved. The movie begins with a bloody shootout on a bridge in Bangladesh. At this moment, the main character, Tyler Rake, is trying to survive amidst a hail of enemy gunfire. After being hit by numerous bullets, Tyler's body is covered in blood and multiple wounds. In his mind, an image of a child playing happily on the beach appears. This dangerous battle began a few days earlier. Ovi, the son of a notorious crime lord in India, went out to play with his friends after school. This angered Saju, the head of his security team. Due to his special background, Ovi couldn't live freely like other kids. He wasn't allowed to play and sociable. That night, Ovi sneaked out of the house and went to a nightclub to hang out with his friends. He and another boy went outside to smoke. However, two policemen approached, killed Ovi's friend immediately with just one shot, and took Ovi away. The guy behind this kidnapping is Amir Asif, a drug lord in Bangladesh and also a rival of Ovi's father. Upon learning the news, Saju immediately informed Ovi's father, who is currently serving a sentence in a prison in Mumbai. Ovi's father was furious and threatened Saju that if he couldn't safely bring Ovi home, he would kill Saju's son. Returning home, Saju was deeply worried about how to rescue Ovi. With his father in prison and their assets seized, he couldn't use money to ransom Ovi. Finally, he came up with a plan to hire a team of mercenaries and use their help to rescue the hostage, despite the high fee involved. The film cut to a scene of Tyler Rake, a skilled mercenary, who was currently living in Australia. He jumped down from a very high cliff. As he plunged into the water, he continued to hold his breath and stayed there for a while. Tyler drove home, where Nick, a member of the mercenary group and also Tyler's teammate, was already waiting. She came to recruit him for a mission to rescue the son of a crime lord, and he agreed. The next morning, Tyler met with the whole team to discuss the plan to rescue Ovi. Upon arriving in the city of Dhaka, Bangladesh, Tyler contacted the kidnappers holding Ovi. Immediately, a truck arrived to take him to the location where the hostage was being held. When they met, the kidnappers continuously demanded ransom money, while Tyler insisted on seeing evidence that the boy was still alive. The leader of the kidnappers kept threatening to demand money first, even pointing a gun at Tyler's head, but he showed no sign of fear. Seeing his boldness, the leader eventually allowed him to see Ovi, who was currently tied up in a nearby room. Ensuring that the boy was still alive, Tyler waited patiently for the right moment to rescue him. The kidnappers blindfolded Tyler and took him to another room. On the way, a sniper aligned with Tyler's side shoots one of the kidnappers, allowing Tyler to free himself and rescue Ovi without paying ransom. After knocking down all the bad guys, Tyler quickly took the boy out of the building. Meanwhile, elsewhere in the city, a group of street kids were being gathered for interrogation because they were suspected of stealing from the gang leader, Amir. One boy was even thrown off a roof by one of Amir's henchmen without any mercy. As the henchman was about to throw another child off the roof, a boy named Farhad intervened and claimed that the child just thrown down was the thief. His words caught Amir's attention. Amir called him over, praised his cleverness, and then gave him a knife, telling him to chop off two fingers as a warning to other children. While Farhad hesitated, the city's police chief arrived to inform Amir that the kidnappers had lost Ovi. The drug lord was furious upon hearing this news. As an influential figure in Dhaka and having control over the police force, he immediately ordered the city to be locked down and set up checkpoints at all bridges around Dhaka to search for Ovi. After rescuing Ovi, Tyler took him to the pickup point, made him wear a bulletproof vest, and prepared weapons. He called Nick and other teammates who were ready to take them both safely out of Dhaka. At this point, attack and the entire team was killed. Nick tried to contact the teammates but received no response. She also tried to call the hirer but there's no answer. Now the whole team realized they have been played. Tyler received a warning from Nick and noticed someone tailing him and Ovi. That person is Saju. Saju had planned all this. After Tyler rescued Ovi from the kidnappers, Saju plotted to kill him and his teammates to take credit for the rescue of Ovi. Saju chased after the two, but they managed to get into a car and drove away in time. Just as they escaped from Saju's pursuit, the two were surrounded by Amira's corrupt police force. Tyler must now protect Ovi from both the police and Saju. As the most skilled mercenary, Tyler quickly took down the police force. Suddenly, Saju appeared, and a hand-to-hand combat occurred. While fighting Saju, a car suddenly rushed in and hit Tyler, leaving him stunned on the ground. Saju intended to approach and shoot Tyler, but when he saw Ovi being taken away by the police, he shot them instead and tried to lead the boy away. Saju was hit by Tyler with a truck. Tyler called for Ovi to get in the car, and the boy obeyed. They drove away but were still pursued by the police. As the car went under a bridge, Tyler seized the opportunity, jumped out with Ovi, and escaped into the chaotic crowd, temporarily shaking off both Saju and the police. Once they found a temporary hiding place, Tyler called Nick. She informed him that Saju was the one who hired their team to rescue Ovi and the whole team has been played. She advised him to leave the boy behind since the contract has been cancelled and arranged a helicopter to pick him up to a safe place. However, he refused to abandon the boy due to his haunting memories of his own son. Meanwhile, Saju also called his wife to inform her about the situation, instructing her to take their son far away if he couldn't bring Ovi back. At night, after receiving news that the helicopter was ready, Tyler immediately took Ovi and left. In the dark night, Tyler and Ovi were chased by Amir's henchmen. Since they are just a bunch of kids, they were no match to Tyler. However, the noise of the scuffle alerted the police, who discovered Tyler's location. Tyler and Ovi had to continue fleeing and eventually hide in a nearby sewage drain. When they were temporarily safe, Tyler called Nick again, instructing her to inform Gaspar, a retired former teammate, to come and pick him up. Back at Gaspar's home, Tyler and Ovi were safe, for now. During their conversation, Tyler revealed his painful past. His son died of lymphoma. Unable to bear the sight of losing his beloved son like that, when his son passed away, he wasn't by his side to witness. He was on a mission far away. It's because of this that he always blamed himself and was haunted by the image of his son. This is also the reason why he strived to protect Ovi, as the boy reminded him of his short-lived son. When Ovi fell asleep, Tyler went downstairs. At this point, he realized that Gaspar had informed the police to come and take Ovi away. Gaspar said that if Tyler abandons the boy, everything will end, and he can keep his life and receive $10 million. Ultimately, Gaspar only had good intentions to help his friend, but Tyler cannot abandon the boy. An altercation happened between them. While they were fighting, Ovi came downstairs with a gun in hand and shot Gaspar dead. Tyler contacted Saju, and they agreed to protect Ovi together and help him escape from Dhaka. They planned their escape, with Tyler diverting the police's attention, thereby assisting Saju and Ovi in evading the checkpoints. Meanwhile, Nick and their former teammates were on the other side of the bridge, waiting to take them back to India. They just need to safely cross the bridge, and everything will be over. The journey across the bridge for the three of them was not easy. Saju took responsibility for driving Ovi, while Tyler stood at a nearby building to cover for them. Tyler fired a gun at a nearby car to attract the attention of the police, allowing Saju and Ovi to drive through easily. As they were just driving for a while, they got stuck in traffic. Wanting to avoid detection, they had to get out of the car and walk. As they passed through a checkpoint, they tried to be as discreet as possible. However, a police officer noticed them, and asked the boy to take off his hat. When Ovi removed his hat, Saju immediately shot the nearby officers and fled. After being recognized by the police, Ovi was vigorously pursued. Saju tried his best to protect him, but he was shot dead by the police chief. Later, this police officer was swiftly killed by Nick. Tyler also suffered severe injuries from the shootout with the police. Despite the pain and exhaustion, Tyler still tried to protect Ovi and directed him to run towards his teammates. As the boy was safe beside Nick, Tyler also struggled to get up and move towards his crew. Suddenly, a bullet flew past Tyler's neck, rendering him unable to move forward. Seeing that Ovi was safe, he seemed somewhat relieved, and then he fell into the river, uncertain whether he could survive or not. The film cuts to a scene 8 months after the incident, where Nick has found Amir and shot him dead in a men's restroom. As for Ovi, he returned to school in Mumbai. In the final scene, Ovi jumped into a swimming pool and practiced holding his breath just like Tyler at the beginning of the film. As he got back to the surface, in the distance, there was a familiar figure of a man watching him. So, that's the end for today. Thanks for watching and see you again in the next videos. Peace.